everybody. Erica Sherwood here from Pink Bucker Designs. I've got a fun little treat box for you using the Fruitful Blessings bundle. And I have to tell you, when I first saw this bundle, the thing that attracted me the most was the corn dye. So I'm going to show you how I made these little Indian corns and how to make the treat box too. Inside the treat box is a little package of Scarecrow Crunch Trail Mix. These are from Target. You could put chocolates in here. You could put whatever you want, but I made the box specifically to hold this trail mix package. And Target has lots of different trail mix packages, all the same size, so you could always use this box for different trail mixes. All right, let's make the box first. I'm gonna grab my Simply Scored, and we're gonna use copper clay, and this piece is 7 1/4 by 9 1/2. On the long side, we're gonna score it at 1 4 1/4, 5 1/4, and 8 1/2. On the short side, we're gonna score it at 1 1/2, 1 1/2, and 6 1/4. All right. Now you want to grab your bone folder and burnish these lines. Get them all nice and crisp. The bone folder will help you make sure that your box is straight and even with your score lines being nice and crisp. All right. Now, when we scored the short side, over here we had 1 1/2 and 1 1/2 inch. This piece right here is gonna be the little lip that tucks down into your box. So we're gonna cut off these four and this one and this one. So let me show you. With a 1/2 inch section over here, we're gonna cut these four first. So with your scissors, go right down the middle of your score line and cut that one off there. All right, now we're gonna go all the way in here, but only cut this one off. All right. And now same thing over here, all the way in, but only cut that square off. Okay, now for this one right here, we're gonna cut the corners off of this one. That'll help us tuck it into our box a little easier. Okay, now along the bottom over here, remember our 1/2 inch side is over here, we're gonna cut this corner off. Okay, so just completely cut that corner off. Then I want you to cut the corners, just the corners off of that tab right there. Now, the last thing you gotta do is snip these lines right here. Snip, snip, snip. And this is what your box looks like. Back to its original orientation with a 1/2 inch section over here, this is what your box looks like. I'll turn it this way too so that you can see it if you wanna stop the video. All right, so let's put adhesive along this tab over here on the side. I'm gonna use tear and tape. I think I'm gonna use two pieces. And we'll peel this off and peel this one off. And then if you take your box and just fold it in half, that side will go right over, and then now we've got our box. Can you see it coming together? So down here, fold in the sides first, then the back, and last you're gonna wanna fold in that front tab. Whoops, I didn't tear that off enough. Oh goodness, okay, okay. Let's use the scissors. All right, if I can get these off of my fingers. Tear and tape is really good. All right, now take your backing off. Oh my goodness, this tape's just being very stubborn. And fold that up like that. And there is your box, okay? Let's put our Scarecrow Crunch in and close it up like that. Now I have cut a piece of designer series paper. This is actually the Oh Holy Night designer series paper. And I love this pattern on the back. I love all the patterns actually on the back of that pack of paper. That pack of paper is fabulous. It's got great nativity scene papers, but also it's got some really cool patterns on the opposite sides. All right, so whoops. Now the measurements and the supply list for this project is on a free PDF on my blog. So make sure you click the link here on YouTube, hop over there and grab it. Okay, so now we're gonna make our tag and I'm gonna bring over my grid paper because we're gonna need to protect our work surface a little bit. I have cut a very vanilla label, okay? And I've also cut this very vanilla little tiny flag. Now, here is what I have already cut out using the two corn dies. You've got a top corn and a bottom corn, okay? And you can do the same colors or you can do different colors. On the top layers, I put adhesive sheets on the back before I cut them out. That way, it's going to be a sticker. So get all those little guys, little doodads out, which will come out too sometimes when you pull out your adhesive. This is Cajun Craze. Let me turn that over to the right side. Cajun Craze on top of Pecan Pie. Okay. Now this one we're going to do, this is Crushed Curry on top of Crushed Curry. Okay. So let's peel that backing out and hopefully all those little doodads will come out with it. There we go. And line that up like that. And the next one I actually did opposite of what's on my sample. I've got a cherry cobbler bottom and we're gonna do Blackberry Bliss on the top. Now I wanted my Indian corn to look a little more realistic. So we're gonna add some details. This one I felt like was pretty good. I didn't need to do anything to this one, right? But for the Cajun Craze one, I'm gonna take my Cajun Craze Dark Stampin' Blend and I'm actually gonna color in some of the squares. Now be careful because you don't want to get this where on top of the top layer. So I'm just going to take it and kind of dot it in to about half the holes. Okay, make it look a little more like those corn that have all the different colored kernels. Okay, so there's that one. And then for my yellow one, I'm gonna move everything out of the way. We're gonna flick some color on here. I am gonna take, first, I think I'm gonna take my Cajun Craze and I'm gonna use the brush end and I'm gonna flick color on it like that. Then I'm gonna take my Pecan Pie Dark and flick a little more color on it like that. And now, doesn't that look a little more authentic? I think so. All right, so let's bring our pieces back. I have cut out three of the corn tops, the husk part, from Crumb Cake. And I'm gonna take my small blending brush and some Crumb Cake ink. And I'm just gonna rub ink on it. This is gonna make them a little bit darker and bring out that embossed detail that the die added to the piece. You can see those little lines there. There we go. Okay, so we've got all of those pieces. The last thing I'm gonna do is stamp the sentiment on this very vanilla stitched banner. This is from the Nested Essential Dies. And I'm gonna stamp it in copper clay right on there. Okay, let's put it all together. We've got our very vanilla tag and I'm gonna use lots of dimensionals here. I'm gonna start with my Blackberry Bliss corn. I'm going to put that kind of angled out. And then we'll do our Cajun Craze corn, kind of angled out that way. I think I need to put one on the bottom. Stick that down. And then we'll do our, I think this is my favorite, the one with the flicked color on it. Our crushed curry corn, and put that right in the middle. And then we're gonna take our corn tops, the husks, and we'll put them on with dimensionals. We'll put this one back here like this, and this one like that, and this one I'm gonna put right on top like that. I just think that's so fun. I've never had a corn die before. All right, we're gonna put that like it's a tag hanging off, and we'll grab our linen thread and we're gonna make a small bow. And let's put these, that little bow right there. Okay, now let's attach it to our box. Let's move this messy stuff out of the way. And let me show you, on my original box, I used copper clay ribbon, which is great. But I think on this box, I wanna try this new ribbon. This is gonna be an online exclusive available beginning in November, and it's pecan pie, and it's called center stripe ribbon. So I think, look how beautifully that goes together. All right, so we're gonna take our tag, and I'm gonna come in at the bottom and come out at the top, if I can get it to come through like that. And I'm gonna take some, oops, we don't want it twisted. Let's untwist it. Actually, let's turn it. I like that side better. One side looks a little bit different, I think. Well, maybe not. All right, I'm gonna take my dimensionals, and I'm actually going to make sure you've pulled it enough all the way through. I'm gonna sandwich this ribbon on here. That way, when the ribbon is untied, it will stay stuck to the box, and they won't lose their ribbon and have to try to thread it back through if they wanna close it up and display it, because it's just so cute. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna attach it right there, and then we'll wrap this around. And tie this ribbon right in the middle. And that will hold your treat box closed. This ribbon is perfect for fall. All right, let's snip these off, and we are done. What do you guys think? Which ribbon do you like the best? Boy, I don't know. That's a really hard decision, because I love this ribbon, but I like that ribbon too. Either way, it's adorable. All right, click the link here on YouTube, go back to my blog, get the free PDF, and check out the other Fruitful Blessing projects. Let me know if you have questions, guys. Have fun stamping. Bye-bye.